Thanks, Chito. I think has been mentioned by Bohok about the triple P concept. So what we are doing by bringing in the Prusda, because Bohok discussed it from another point, which is very interesting, to have it embedded into the agreement. So what we are doing, why we bring in the Prusda, the local state-owned company, because we know in Indonesia, Chito, in terms of the infrastructure projects, the typical problem is about land clearance. You know? So we cannot waste our time to deal with the land clearance issue. So we bring in as our partner in the consortium, as I mentioned early, the state, local state-owned company. Now, this one also related later on when we issue sukuk. Let's say, you know, we use akad, whether musharaka, or even, you know, we have to deal with type of istisna sukuk. But one thing is very clear. In Indonesia, it is a bit difficult, Chito, to employ the asset-backed sukuk, you know. So because there is a transfer of the title to the SPV, if we use the asset-backed sukuk, so we rely more on the asset-based sukuk. Now, asset-based sukuk will be relevant if we are dealing, let's say, with the power plant projects, because PLN down here is also another state-owned company. They will issue PPA, power purchase agreement. Mm-hmm. So we can leverage again the power purchase agreement when we construct the sukuk as our asset-based sukuk. So this is also related to the issue in terms of the, I think it's very interesting, Bohok just mentioned before. So we have issue you know, with the land clearance. Yeah, solve it by bringing the concept of triple P. And also, moreover, we can employ Islamic triple P. And also in terms of the type of the sukuk itself, whether it is asset-backed sukuk or asset-based sukuk, will also another thought to discuss. Because some other projects, let's say like the non-power plant project, in the absence of the power purchase agreement, we then have to deal with the asset-backed sukuk, you know, to make it more as what you call it, appealing to the investors. So refinery projects, for example, in the absence of the offtake agreement with Pertamina, another state-owned company, so then we will be dealing with asset-backed sukuk. And the last point I would like to mention is the nature of the sukuk, whether it is musyaraka sukuk and whether this is ijara sukuk, so we can deal easily. But again, the concept of musyaraka sukuk is something that we would like to promote in terms of the infrastructure projects in Indonesia.